Guys, it's Jeff Lafferty, Artcast 434, and I believe it's day 20 of my 100 Days of Comics challenge. I don't know if you guys can tell, but I've got a cold. We went out to eat last night, and I don't know, maybe somebody sneezed on my food or something, but I got a sore throat this morning and don't feel that great. But we did go see The Avengers last night, and wow, man, what a movie. That was a great movie. You know, I recommend anybody that's thinking about going to see it, go see it, because it is awesome. I love the end of it. I love the way they tied the characters together. I mean, I think it's might be better than the first Avengers, and it might be the best superhero movie yet, you know? I mean, it was really good. I'm super impressed the way Marvel keeps pumping out great movies, you know? I keep thinking, no, they're going to get bad, they're going to get worse, and no, man, this was a great one. Now, yesterday, you know, I made the video about this Richard Myers, and had a lot of comments, a lot of kind of infighting in the comments. I kind of went in and tried to calm things down, and I don't think I really did. But, you know, like, everybody's got their opinion on this dude, you know? And it's like, that's what's cool about America. Somebody said I went over the top with, like, free speech yesterday. Well, I'm going over the top with, like, living in America today. Because, like, that's what's cool about America is that, you know, you get your opinion. And nobody can come along and take it away from you. You know what I mean? And so, like, everybody's opinion on this guy, I appreciate. Like, I'm not on one side or the other. I'm on the side of, hey, you know, stick up for what you believe in. If you're for this guy, do that. And if you're against this guy, then trash him. But as I was kind of responding to the comments, I kind of, you know, started to think about something. And I wrote it in the comments, and I'm going to kind of repeat it here. But my question is this guy genuine? Is what he's doing what he really believes in? Because, you know, you got his book on one side, and his book's like, you know, it's not controversial, it's just a book, you know? And you got that stuff happening with his book, but on the other side, you got his channel. And he seems to be attacking artists in hopes that they'll attack him back. And why I say this is, like, yesterday I went to his channel again. And just since I had been on his channel like a day before, he, he attacked two more artists. And not in a nice way. This guy, Saladin Ahmed, he called him a racist and all this stuff, you know. And this other guy, John Layman, and he basically just insulted him and called him all kinds of names. And, I think a normal, sane person, like, what would you expect from that, you know? What would you expect to happen from that? And, like, my question is, like, what's he trying to get out of that? And from just an outside perspective, I'd say he's just trying to get a fight going. He wants Saladin Ahmed. He wants Saladin Ahmed to come back and say, hey, fuck you, dude. You know what I mean? And all of Saladin Ahmed's fans to come rushing over and attack him. And then he wants to send out his fans towards this guy. And then they can all have a big old internet fight. And at the end of that, he ends up with, like, you know, another 20 or 30,000 subscribers. So that's my question today, I guess. If anybody wants to comment, I don't know. You guys might be over this. And I'm a little bit over it, too. He's actually made $300,000 on that Indiegogo, not $200,000. So, you know, either way, he's basically, you know, if he's smart about the Kickstarter and he actually ships everything and does it right, then he's made a ton of money and you know, sold a ton of books. So, you know, it's like either way, he's won. He can still, you know, self-publish and try to go through Diamond. And, you know, then it's up to the comic shops and the customers whether they actually buy the thing, whether it actually is any good. So it's kind of a moot point, I think, at this point, because, you know, he's made 300 grand. If I made 300 grand on, you know, the first issue of Berserkonaut, I don't know if I'd be complaining so much. But if it was my business model, you know, if this guy's really doing it just to stir up shit and that's how he gets subs, it's something to think about, you know? It's something to think about if you're on that guy's side. Is he playing you guys? Is he playing the fans like a fiddle at a barn dance? I don't know. But he could be. You know, and the same could go for Mark Wade. He's like an outspoken comics pro. And he's coming on the internet and fighting it out with some dude on the YouTube. It's almost like, George Lucas getting on the internet and fighting with the fans that don't like Star Wars. It's kind of crazy, It's like, why would you do that? I think it would be actually kind of comical if like these two were actually best friends and they just came up with this whole scheme to just sell this damn book, So anyway, if you guys are so inclined, you can comment. Everybody's got their own opinions. Everybody's got a right to speak their mind, and everybody's got a right to hate this guy, and everybody's got a right to like him. You know what I mean? It's like you got rights, and especially on my channel, because that's the way I believe, and this is my little kingdom on the internet. So, thanks for watching, guys. Sign up for the mailing list to get notifications every time a video comes out. Sign up on Patreon. I really appreciate what's going on Patreon. I'm almost up to $100 on Patreon, so I really appreciate that. And that is very cool. So thank you guys. See you tomorrow.